Good afternoon. Hi, my name is Subrato Paul. I passed out in 1974 in mechanical engineering and I was in RP Hall. But immediately after my engineering, I went off to London Business School to do an MBA. So that was a two-year program. And but unlike, you know, most of my colleagues during those days, 74, I returned to India after there were some personal reasons I returned to India after 76, that's 2 years of MBA program. And I then had a 36 years of career holding, you know, various CEO positions. I think my first CEO position was when I was 34. I was the chief executive of a television manufacturing company way back in 1985. So just after 9 years of work experience, I'd become a CEO. So coming back to, if you want to take up management as a career, quickly going through, when you take up an internship, I would suggest that you focus on projects which have business outcomes. It's things like, I'll give you if you are in an infrastructure company doing a project, you could do a project like saying that last 5 years, all projects over 50 crores, what are the cost of, and over 50 crores which have been delayed, I will calculate for you for those, you know, 10 or 15 projects, the cost of delay. No, so you have to do projects which have a business outcome. So similarly, like if you were in a power company, you could analyze a distribution loss over the past as an internship. And so you should go there and suggest something which you're sure that it will lead to some business outcome, which then for that company they are interested in looking at, and it also helps you to understand what's the real life business problems and issues. In the same thing, when you do your internal projects, you have to do a final year project, and take projects which have business outcomes. So keep that as a thing. If you want a management as a career, start getting into things which have business outcomes rather than just some esoteric technical project, which may sound very interesting but may not be that useful. Coming back to extracurricular activities and co-curricular activities, you should be involved in things where you can, develop your organizing abilities, your leadership capabilities, either in the gymkhana or in your hall. Be involved in organizing things, and you may, if you're a good debater, if you're a good quizzer, if you're a sportsman, that's fine. But over and above that, try to get into roles where you can help in organizing, where you can take some leadership. Now coming back to, all that is the preparatory stage. Now you have to take a decision about an MBA program. My suggestion is that if you're taking in India, just look at the top 20 or top 50. Don't waste your time going beyond. And the top 20 will include, I think, the 10 IIMs, and then there are the XLRIs, the Faculty of Management Studies, SPJM. You can find it out. You go through any of the listings, either Business Week, Business World, Business India, Business Today. They have good listing. Even India Today has a good listing, Business School. So choose the top 20. Now, then the next question is, I'll tell you among the top 3 IIMs, ABC, we call it ABC, Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Calcutta. In that, you will find that, now the next issue is, should I do it immediately or should I go for work experience? My advice, there may be a debate on this advice. My advice is that if you can get into the top 20 without work experience, go for it. But if you don't get it in the top 15, then go for your work experience and then do your it. But don't compromise on which institute you're going. That would, you should not compromise. If you want to go abroad, if you have any plans, then there you require 3 years of work experience. That's fundamental. And there also, again, if you're going to do 3 years of work, you should only aim for the top 15, 20. that again you can find out the Business Week or Financial Times documentary. That's easy to find out. And focus on that. Now in terms of if you are, then if you go abroad, then if you are going to spend $100,000 or $100,000, it'll be $100,000 plus anyway, you know, $100,000 to $150,000, then you probably may have to think of, you know, staying back and doing work there. But now let's come back, if you were looking at career options in India. If you were doing it from one of the IIMs or one of the, you know, faculty management studies, Accelerai or others, then the opportunities you'll get is in financial services, which includes investment banking. You'll get consultancy, you'll get FMCG sector, you can, telecom is another sector where you will have, you know, opportunities. And infrastructure is coming up as a sector and one should look into it. There are not too many MBAs there, but there's a lot of, you know, interesting structuring coming up, business models of how to do the infrastructure projects. So that's an area one should consider as a career option after an MBA. Other than the standard ones, I told you, consultancy, investment banking, so financial services, telecom and ITs. These would be the traditional sectors where you could go in. And because manufacturing and all, you can go in, but I don't think so there are as many opportunities for an MBA. And if you were in consultancy or in investment banking and you have aspirations of a CEO, then what you should do is, if you have joined a Bain's or a McKinsey or whatever, then you should look that you should transition after 10 years into a CXO. That's a functional head. So if you want to get into leadership, okay, you can become a managing partner of the consultancy and all that, but those are limited. They can be in the top 5 consultancies, only top 5 CEO. So as I said, consultancy and also investment banking. If you want to stick and go on making money in investment banking, fine. But if you want a CEO role in future, then 10 years is the time when you should, both if you are in consulting or in investment banking, to switch over. In the other sectors, you will get a, over time, if you're doing well, you'll get a CEO role. Will always be. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.